It's Q101 Jamboree. I'm Kevin Manno here with OK Go in the house. They just got here. You guys just got in from California.
We did.
That's right.
We did. And it's not raining.
I know. This turned out to be the best day. Everybody all week was, the forecast was nothing but rain.
The pilot told us it was going to rain.
The pilot told us it was raining.
Yeah.
What a liar.
I know. He's a total liar. Actually, the thing is, I actually kind of like rain at festivals.
Yeah.
I know that's douchey of me to say.
No, not at all. I mean, I think the spectators enjoy it as well.
It can give it kind of a majestic feel.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, and it's sort of a wheat from the chaff kind of thing. You know what I mean? Like the sissies all leave, and you get like the people who really want to rock.
Yeah. Mud fights.
Yeah, it's. I mean, obviously we usually have. I mean, there's usually a something over stage, so at least we're not getting electrocuted with the guitars. And I kind of like it when it's like everybody in the crowd is as sweaty as you are.
That's a good way to look at it. I want to talk about, you guys are about to close down the Cubby Bear side stage for the night. You're the headliner.
That's right.
You mentioned you just flew here and the pilot was lying to you. Every time you walk on a plane, do you hope it's Solenberger, the guy?
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah.
I love that dude.
I kind of try to peek in there.
Yeah. Although he shouldn't hit the birds.
Yeah.
He's a bird killer.
Yeah, exactly.
Where are you at, PETA? Get on him. PETA. He's a bird killer.
Bird Slayer.
Well, thanks for being here. You guys are you're the headliner on the Cubby Bear side stage.
Thank you for having us. We're very proud to be
back.
We're
all very excited about it. Do you consider yourselves a Chicago band?
Yeah, we do. I mean, it's we haven't lived here in a while. You know, both of us were Chicago transplants. I grew up in Washington, D.C.
I grew up in Michigan.
Okay.
Yeah. But Tim went to college here, and I moved here after college, and we lived here for about 6 years, and it's still where the band started and kind of where we feel most. I don't know. It's where we're most connected to. We both followed girls to the West Coast, basically, and now we're left stuck out there.
It's sort of a weird. There aren't too many bands that, you know what I mean? You guys are a Chicago band. You consider yourselves that, but sort of. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you've got roots elsewhere, and you move around, and I don't know. It's like, do you feel plugged into the Chicago scene? Were you when you were just starting?
We certainly were when we were living here. The thing is, local scenes, I mean, really good local scenes change so fast. You know? I mean, the reason we were in Chicago was because it was so awesome at that time. I mean, the music scene was so, like, Drag City and I don't know, Tortoise and Don Cap.
Tortoise
and
is the best. I love Tortoise.
It was just, like, such a good time for music in Chicago, and everybody we knew was in a band. You know what I mean? I seriously, like, when we played our first show, there was, like, 300 kids there, and I remember looking out and being like, I don't think there's 10 of them that aren't in bands that I've gone to see. You know?
All our roommates were in bands.
And it was so great. And, of course, it's 10 years later, everybody's spread out around the country and stuff. So we feel very connected to those people, but those people aren't the Chicago scene anymore.
Right,
so,
it does change very quickly. I just had the same conversation with the Alkaline Trio a couple weeks ago.
Oh, yeah.
Same thing for them. I mean, that just... It evolved so quickly.
Yeah, I mean, I grew up in D.C. and was, like, you know, really, really tied into the D.C. scene in the, like, late 80s, early 90s. And it was the same thing. It was, like, you know, it was so intense and so much awesome stuff happening. And you go away for 2 or 3 years, you come back, and you don't know anyone anymore. You know, it just moves so fast.
Is Fugazi from D.C.?
Yeah. Fugazi, that's basically, awesome. They were, like, the grandpas of the scene. You know, it's like they... In fact, I started a record label when I was 15 with a loan that Ian, the singer from Fugazi, gave me.
Really?
And he didn't, no contracts for anything. He was like, he gave me $2,000 and he was like, I've got about $5,000 that I use like this. And if you don't pay this back to me, then I won't have it to use. And you will be the kid who shut down the DC
scene. So I assume you paid it back.
I had it back to him in like 2 weeks.
Look at
you. Was like, because what are you going to do? Like, cross Ian MacKay? You know, it's like, yes, sir, daddy, sir.
Do you guys get sick of talking about the music videos?
No.
Can we talk about...
Let's talk about the music videos.
This Too Shall Pass.
Yeah. Yes.
I mean, honestly, I know everyone says it, but one of the coolest things I've ever seen. What is the thing? What's it called?
It's called a Rube Goldberg machine.
There you go.
Although most people think of it as like Mousetrap, you know, like that game Mousetrap. And so it's, you know, it's like, you know, you hit the dominoes and the dominoes hit the ball.
Were you a little kid drawing these on notebooks and stuff? Because I
totally,
was. I mean, you know, then the shoe falls and it hits the chicken and he lays an egg. And
Absolutely. Yeah. And it was like when we realized that... We'd never seen a machine like that that was actually set to music. You know, you see lots of them on the internet, and they're like, they're always really exciting. And we realized we'd never actually seen one kind of like dancing, basically. So
how do you do it? Like, there's a thing where, you know, the spoons are hitting the glasses, and it's to the beat. I mean, this was to the second.
That's science,
it was,
man.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We were quite literally dropping science.
I can't even watch it. It just blows my mind. And this might be. I shouldn't ask. Was it one take?
The video is one take. It took us 89 tries to get it.
But the actual finished product was
there's
one
an
take.
Edit. There's an edit. Like, basically, you go around the top floor, you go down an elevator shaft,
and
around
the curtains
going
open.
Going down the shaft is from a different take. The machine got to the end 3 times out of 89 tries. But we didn't. The cameraman on the one take we really liked. The cameraman didn't catch the water stuff.
Bastard.
Well, no. Come on. I mean, he was.
I'm
like
kidding.
A genius.
I'm joking. Yeah.
So we edited that over. It is one take. We just edited that part over it. So.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Well, it's amazing. It is one of the coolest things I've ever seen. And you just told me over there that you're doing 2 new videos this summer.
Yeah. We've got one that's coming out. We're playing at Bonnaroo next weekend.
Next weekend.
Wow. We're playing at Bonnaroo next weekend, and we're premiering the new video at Bonnaroo. And then
can I have a taste?
Yeah. Of what?
The video. What? I mean, can you?
Damn,
can you,
I was
you,
hoping you wanted something really juicy.
Can I lick you?
There
you go.
The video
a taste
is
of your mustache.
As you may have come to expect from us, it's all one shot. But this time, the shot is 21 hours long, and we compressed it down to 4 minutes.
And are you in it?
Yeah.
So you did something
the
for 21 hours?
We did a lot of things for 21 hours. Yeah, we actually had to choreograph our sleep and stuff. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's awesome.
And so, do you guys feel pressure to keep?
No,
keep it going.
I mean, you feel pressure.
Keep one-upping yourself.
You feel internal pressure to keep making awesome stuff, and it's like, it's not to get more people or to like, you know, we don't like look at our art in terms of metrics. You know, right. We're not like we need more views. It's, but every time something succeeds, it makes it that much easier to try to like set your sights even higher.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's the. Not every video will appeal to like 95-year-olds. I mean, the treadmills and the Rube Goldberg machine. Literally, people stop Tim in Times Square, like little old ladies, 75-year-old women come like,
"That's awesome!
You're the treadmill boy!"
Well, that's cool as hell. Yeah. I mean, that's you know, nice. And it's getting your music out there to people that would never hear you.
Absolutely.
Right. Does it ever overshadow the music? Does that worry you?
No, I mean, it would worry us if they were advertisements. You know what I mean? Like, the way music videos were in 1995 or even 2002 was basically like a record label pays for you to make a video, or rather pays for them to make a video advertising the CD that they're selling. You know, we make our videos because we want to. It's not like they're advertising.
And we make them.
Yeah, I mean, we make them ourselves. They're not, we don't even have a major label anymore. Bam!
That's awesome. Congratulations.
Yeah, it's so great. So we just like, you know, it's asking if they overshadow the music is sort of like being like, does your live show overshadow your records?
Right.
You know, it's like, it's all part of one thing to us. Like we get to chase our craziest ideas all the time. And that's just like, that's our dream. You know what I mean?
Cool. Good. Well, I'm going to let you guys go. You're doing the Cubby Bear side stage just a couple minutes from now, I guess.
Yeah. Yes.
Headlining the side stage, the Cubby Bear side stage. That's amazing. Okay, go. This is the Q101 Jamboree. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you, Q101. You.